So hello everyone again, and finally we reached our second class, and now we are going to start to code and to properly do some coding. And basically our second class is regarding installing the dependencies. So in the second class, it is a little, I think that is the short class of the course, basically. It is just for installing the dependencies that we are going to have in our project. And now also having an introduction about ESLint and Prettier, which are two tools that we are going to use for code quality. Basically, ESLint, it is a tool that checks for errors, for formatting errors, for any kind of errors syntax errors that may be found on your code. So this is will help us through the course to maintain a very good quality of code. To don't have this, every time someone is coding, it is usually you do some kind of Frankenstein code where you have a lot of unformatted code with some code smell, with some code issues. So we are going to use ESLint for doing the syntax formatting and error checking, and we are going to use this another tool which is called Prettier, which is a tool for formatting. Like if we have a project that is not identity, and or you have irregular tabbing on your project, basically we are going to use Prettier for just formatting these automatically. So we are going to have a formatted file, this of course will improve the aspect and the way that we can view our file. It gives a better appearance to the file actually. So basically, but those two tools already comes if you switch to the class 2 branch. There is no need to configure this one. If you go to the Visual Studio Code, there is a file that is called eslint.json and another file called Prettier erc.json, and under those two files I have already wrote the configuration, because it's not the goal of this course to teach about those two tools, but it's good to use it. And basically all the developers, they doesn't know how to configure this. They just copy from somewhere and use it, because it is just the aim here is to make sure that those tools are going to help us to maintain our code better and more prettier and with a good appearance. So basically we have those two files that we are not going to touch basically, and this file, and today we are going to go, just remember I'm the branch of the class 2. If you are going to go to follow this class, you can switch to the class 2, or you can do everything in a single branch and just update the code as you watch new classes here on YouTube, or in another platform that you are watching this class. But basically here, if we go to package.json, which is the file that contains the information of our project, what is the name of our project, what are the dependencies of the projects, and for the ones that doesn't know what are dependencies are basically another libraries, another code base that are needed to run our project. Imagine if we had to do everything by the scratch, like imagine if we had to do everything without any framework, anything. This would be a very painful thing. So as we have our dependencies, we have people that already wrote another libraries, we can use those libraries, and those are defined here in this package.json. This file, it is formatted as a JSON file. If you don't know what is the JSON file, you can search, but it's basically a way of formatting files, a format of file. And here we have our scripts, which are scripts that are going to be used to run our project, to make our project clear. We have the dev script, which is for just running our project in the dev environment. We have the build for building our project, when you are going to push this to production. We have start, which is basically the same thing as dev, to start our project to take a look how it is going. We have the type check, just to check the types when we are using TypeScript, and lint, which is It is a command, the script that we will invoke, ESLint, that will do all the formatting automatically for us. So if we have an unformatted code, we can just run this command that all our project will be formatted in a single command. So basically here, we have this, and the first thing that we are going to do is, if you don't have the terminal open here on your VS Code, just go here up above and terminal and new terminal. And we are going to type here npm. If you don't have npm installed on your computer, the npm is the node package manager. And if you don't have it installed, you just need to go to npm and install it. You can basically you need to download first node. Node.js, which is a model of JavaScript for running JavaScript on your computer, because basically the browser is a JavaScript interpreter, but basically you also download Node for make your computer available to read Node.js too. So basically you need to install Node that you will be able to execute this command. And if you enter here, you're going to be available to download for Mac, Windows, or even Ubuntu or another Linux distributions. So coming back to our code, you just need to type npm install that all of those dependencies that are on the file will be automatically fetched. So there is no need for you to install everything. It's just a single command and you are going to be ready to install everything. So basically that's it. And now we need to wait a little bit, actually. We need to wait a little bit for installing everything. It also, of course, depends of how is your internet connection and everything, but it doesn't take maximum than 10 seconds at all. So now what we are going to do basically is creating a single page just to check if everything is installed and working. So basically here on the project, all of the pages of our application will be placed in a folder that's called pages. So just go here to new folder and type pages. And we will have this folder here, and just go here in under the pages. We are going to create a file that is named index.tsx. It is basically the when we are doing TypeScript projects in React, instead of being JSX, we are going to use TSX. So we created the TSX file. You can hit Command S or Control S to save your project. And basically we are going to start now to do our code. So basically let's first import React, which is our framework React from React. Everything will be automatically fetched because, like, if you take a look here, we'll just complain that it's declared but never use it, but it will stop to complain in a while. So we are going to define our first component, which is index. And this, as we are using TypeScript, we have to give a type to this, so it will be React dot functional component. And we are going to do this in a functional component way using arrow functions. So let's go. So we have the body of our index component, and we just need to do the return, which is it's going to return what will be rendered by this component. So this is where it comes, the TSX or GSX, which is the HTML together with JavaScript. But here we are going to use just a single div. We are going to use this single div, and we are going to name it as, we're going to give a title to this that will be hum. Basically, and now we are going to use a h1 tag for this, and we are going to type hello next.js. Just type this. Oh, my caps is not, it was not working, my caps. Basically now, and we are just going here, down below, we are going to support default index, which we are going to default to support our function component. And as we can see here, we have some formatting errors. If we stop the mouse here, we can see that printer. Also, another thing that you need to do is you need to go here under these extensions. And if you don't have a ESLint installed, just search here, ESLint. I have this already installed, and just go to install. And the same thing goes with Prettier. You go to Prettier here, search for this extension and install it too. So let's get back to our code here up above. And basically, if we can take a look at this ESLint is already detecting Prettier, and if we do something wrong in the code, it will tell that it's not better formatted. So we can just go here to quick fix and fix this. Like magically will fix. And this is also complaining that we haven't entered additional line. We can go to quick fix too. Another way to address here or to fix this, it is I can save my file here. And I can go and run the command npm run lint. That is going to formatly automatically everything for us. Oh, that's like magic. That's a good thing because it's going to format the entire project for you. And if you want to run the project, currently now we are not going to run. Effectively, you're going to run our first version of the project in your third class. But if you want to run, you just need to type npm run npm run dev. That we are going to start project that are going to run, and you will be able to access this through localhost 3000 actually. So for example, of course that we don't have a very fancy UI, but now if you go to your browser, let's switch here to the another tab and go to localhost 3000, you are going to be able to access the page that you just have created. This is just a dummy because we are just testing if everything is installed and everything is okay. But in the next class, we are going to effectively start working with the components and building our components. And we are going to effectively start to build the UI that we are going to use in this entire course. So thanks a lot. I hope you guys enjoyed this class. Just remember that those classes are sponsored by Xing, an amazing company that you can find remote jobs all around the world. And you can work with amazing clients like Fox and Riot Games. And if you like this video, just subscribe here and leave your comment, leave it a like too. And thanks a lot and see you in the next class, which will be the third class that is called Creating the First Page. So thanks a lot, everyone.